The little girl, she lived in a beautiful yard. She had lots of friends. There were birds and bees and bugs and trees. She lived a happy, happy life. And I want to tell you a story now about how Ted Teeple and Honey Smellgood became friends in the beautiful yard. It's a really, really happy story. Shall I share it? The little girl, she was sitting on her porch one day and she looked out on the T-shaped pole in the yard. He was a big iron T-shaped pole. His name was Ted Teepole. Ted Teepole had lived in the yard for a very, very long time. Once upon a time, there was another big iron T-shaped pole across the yard from him. His name was Thomas. Between Ted and Thomas, five wires hung tight and taut for many, many years. The lady would come and hang the family's clothes on the clothesline. So Ted and Thomas had a really happy life. They had a purpose. You know, it's really very important to have a purpose in life. They lived a wonderful life. They were happy to see the little lady come out every day, the diapers, and then the toddler, and the family grew, and life was wonderful. And they had a purpose. One day, a big truck came into the yard and it backed down the driveway. You know how it sounds when they're... And they took a big, giant box out of the truck. And it was a big, white, square. And the lady was like, yay, yay, yay. I never have to don't have to hang clothes on the line anymore. I have an electric dryer. Ted and Thomas didn't know what the big white box was. They didn't know the next day when the lady didn't come, why. They didn't know why she didn't come the next day. Or the next, or the next, or the next. They didn't know why years passed without the lady visiting. But they did know that the wires started rusting and they started breaking. And they started thinking, what is our purpose? What's my purpose? What am I supposed to be here for? And they realized, we don't have a purpose. We have no more purpose. But they had each other. Ted and Thomas had each other looking across the yard. And the little girl would come out and she would play around with the birds and the bees and the flowers and the trees. You know? So Ted and Thomas were fine. They didn't have a purpose, but they had each other. There's the trees. You know? Man. So one day, Texas is at each other. It's really famous for hurricanes. You know? And sure enough, today, the big storm.
Texas is at each other.
And the giant oak tree. This giant oak tree. And tumbling down right on Thomas.
It's
really famous for hurricanes. You know? Ted didn't know yet, but all of a sudden, Ted was alone. He had no purpose.
For hurricanes.
And he had no one. He had no one.
Ted didn't know yet.
But all of a sudden, Ted was alone. for Ted.
Ted didn't know yelling
at her. He touched her.
Ted was wrong about that.
Girl was walking in the forest one day, and a deep, dense forest, and she came upon a tiny, tiny little flower. It was a tiny little flower on a honeysuckle vine. Tiny little flower on a honeysuckle vine. And the little girl said, "Oh my gosh, your little flower is so beautiful." And the honeysuckle vine replied, "Yes, thank you so much. I'm very proud of her. My name is Honeysuckle. And we're very proud. But we don't have any sun. The forest is too dense. The trees are too. We barely just have one tiny, tiny little ray of sun. And only like an hour of the day. But yes, isn't my little flower so beautiful?" The little girl went home, and she was sitting on the front porch, and she was looking out at Ted Peephole, and she remembered Honeysuckle, and she thought, "Oh my gosh, I have the greatest idea." The next morning, she burst from her house after breakfast, and she ran to the forest, and she said to Honey Smell Good, "Do you think you would like to come live in my beautiful yard? I know a place with plenty of sun. I know a place where you won't even just have one tiny little flower. You'll have many little flowers, and you'll have so many friends. It's a beautiful yard. Do you think you'd like to go live
there? I know a place with plenty of..."
"Of course I would. Are you kidding?" And the little flower was like so excited. So the little girl, she dug around the honeysuckle vine very gently and very carefully. And she placed that vine in the wheelbarrow. And she took it back to the beautiful yard. And she went up to Ted Peephole, and said, "I have a friend, Ted Peephole, who needs some sun. Do you think you could help her? She needs a place to grow. And do you think you could help my friend, honey?" And Ted Peephole said, "Well, yes, of course I can. Of course I'll go help your friend." So the little girl dug carefully around the ground, around the big iron T-shaped hole, and she planted Honey Smell Good there. And Honey Smell Good started to grow. And so this is the story. It's the story of Ted Peephole had a purpose again. He gave Honey Smell Good and all her beautiful, beautiful friends a place to grow and thrive in the sun. Honey Smell Good also gave Ted a purpose. She gave Ted friends, the birds and the bees and the butterflies. He was no longer this hot iron pole that nobody could land on or nobody could fly around. Suddenly, everybody was coming to visit him. He was not alone anymore. Ted was not alone. He had a purpose. Honey Smell Good had the sun and had never even seen the sky before. They learned so many things that first night even, and I could tell you all about that. I'll have to wait for later. I could tell you about how Honey Smell Good saw a rainbow for the first time and how he explained that to her. Anyway, the beautiful yard is a beautiful place to be, where you learn lessons about being kind and about respect and growth and The beautiful yard. You know, there's another story about the beautiful yard. It's not quite so happy. It's a story about where in the street in front of the beautiful yard, the vulture came. That's what everybody called him anyway. He was a vulture, but everybody called him the Vulture King. The Vulture King saw someone throw a tiny little kitten out of the car into the ditch. He witnessed it. He saw the tiny little kitten being thrown out. And he saw the tiny little kitten scurry into the woods. The Vulture King, he explained to everybody that this little kitten, yeah, he may be feral, and that's what they did name him, Ferris. Ferris the cat was a mean little cat. He was mean. Everybody in the yard taught all their young that don't go near Ferris. He's mean. He'll kill you. And he would. He's a feral cat. But the Vulture King, he was like, don't you know why? Don't you know why he's so mean? He's so mean because he never learned to trust anyone. He never learned to believe and trust in anyone. He learned that he was always going to be alone. That he was always going to be searching for his food. He was always going to be searching for a dry place to sleep. The little cat, he was mean because that's the way life had taught him to be. He had never had a kind friend. He was mean because that's what he was taught to do. But until one day,
and the dog was straight for the little girl. Thank you. depend on each other, they learn from each other, they love each other.
Thank you.